Hello everyone, welcome to StudyIQ. In this video, I will bring to you the third part of May first week. If you have not seen part 1 and part 2, first check those out. First week I have covered into three parts and this is part 3. StudyIQ sale has started today onwards. It will run for 5 to 6 days. This is the best time if you want to buy any of our best selling paid courses. Just go to website studyiq.com for more details. Do follow me on Instagram. I am coming live on Instagram these days and I'm conducting quizzes also. So my ID is tireless soul. Let's start. In which city was an exhibition on Indian civilization titled India and the World, a history in 9 stories was inaugurated? It was inaugurated in New Delhi. It was conducted in National State Museum. Now Delhi's, Arvind Kejriwal is CM, and Delhi became the first state or union territory in India where the customers will be compensated if there is a unplanned power cut. And we are talking about Indian civilization. One of the most important was the Indus Valley civilization, and there is a place in Haryana called Rakhi Gadi. Rakhi Gadi is in Hisar district and some recent excavations have been done here. So this place is very important. Who has been appointed as the new head coach of Australian cricket team? He is the coach and he will replace Darren Lehman, who resigned following the ball tampering incident. His name is Justin Langer. Justin Langer. Australia's Prime Minister is Malcolm Turnbull. Who swore in as the chief executive member, which is called CEM, of the Chakma Autonomous District Council in Mizoram? His name is Shanti Jiban Chakma. And CADC, it was founded in 1972. It was formed in 1972 under the sixth schedule of the constitution. And Lieutenant General Nirbhay Sharma is the governor of Mizoram. Lieutenant General Nirbhay Sharma. Mizoram is one of the rare states in India which now has a Congress government. Congress government is in Karnataka, in Puducherry, in Mizoram and so on. Mizoram's capital is Aizwal. Which of the following won the Best Cooperative Society on Digital Platform Award in the BFSI? That is banking, finance, insurance and so on. It is called BFSI Sector Leadership Awards 2018. It was won by Adarsh Credit. Adarsh Credit. Now remember that there is a new small finance bank in India that has been opened, which is called the Jana Small Finance Bank. Jan Small Finance Bank. Who led the Indian delegation in the 12th informal meeting of the SAARC finance ministers that was held in Manila? India was represented by Subhash Chandra Garg. Subhash Chandra Garg. SAARC is headquartered in Kathmandu, capital of Nepal, and SAARC chairman is Amjad Sial. Amjad Sial is from Pakistan. Remember that. And it coincided with the 51st meeting of the Asian Development Bank also. Asian Development Bank is headquartered in Manila, capital of Philippines. So in Manila only we have the headquarter of ADB. Ministry of Women and Child Development held a national conference of how many districts under Beti Bachao Beti Padhao in New Delhi. There was a conference of 244 districts. And there is a 115 aspirational district scheme by the Niti Aayog also, where we have selected 115 backward districts of India. Now Maneka Gandhi, she was the chief guest and she's also the Minister for Women and Child Development. And Rakesh Srivastav is a secretary in the Ministry of Women and Child Development. Maharashtra government has announced to rename which university after Bahinabai Chaudhary? Bahinabai Chaudhary. It is the North Maharashtra University. North Maharashtra University. It is a Jalgaon based university and now it will be called Kavyatri Bahinabai Chaudhary North Maharashtra University after the great female poet or poetess, as they say, Bahinabai Chaudhary. Maharashtra, there is a state dance called Lavani and Mumbai is the capital. And Tarapur and Jaitapur are two important nuclear power plants here. There is a Koyna Dam also in Maharashtra, quite famous. National Disaster Management Authority called NDMA, it conducted a workshop on data requirements for disaster risk reduction database in which city? Disaster risk reduction database. It was attended by UNICEF, UNDP, UNISDR also. So it was in New Delhi. New Delhi. Which company has acquired Belgian company called Hedera Consulting? It has been acquired by Cognizant, the IT company. India and China have resumed the bilateral trade through which pass? It is called the Nathula border. Nathula border. Kottayam Pushpanath passed away. He was a what? He was a novelist. He used to write in Malayalam. That's a state language of Kerala. So the answer is novel. Which Nobel Prize for 2018 has been postponed by the Swedish Academy? And instead of one next year, they will give two. This is the Nobel Prize for Literature. It won't be awarded this year. This is decided by the Swedish Academy. And the reason is because of the Me Too campaign. Allegations of sexual harassment made against the husband of one of the members of the Swedish Academy. Me Too campaign. Paekyong Airport is going to become the 100th airport operational in India. It is located in which state? It is located in Sikkim. One more airport was in news. Mopa Airport in Goa. It is being made cargo hub in India. And then Mangaluru Airport was declared the cleanest airport of India among the 53 airports ranking that was declared recently. So remember, Sikkim is the only state in India that does not have an airport. Now Paekyong Airport has come to is like a lease of life. And SpiceJet flights will operate from Paekyong Airport under the Udaan scheme. So it will be from Paekyong, they will go to Kolkata. What was the theme of the World Press Freedom Day? World Press Freedom Day, the theme was keeping power in check. Keeping power in check, media, justice and the rule of law. And 3rd May, it was observed on. Which state chief minister launched Go To Village? Khungang Chatsi mission in the state. This is a language of Manipur. So the answer is Manipur. Capital is Imphal. There is a Loktak Lake in Manipur. Who has been appointed as an additional director to the ICICI Bank's board? His name is Radhakrishnan Nair. And Chanda Kochar is the president of ICICI. Which state has become the first to provide digitally signed land record receipts? They are digitally signed. It is Maharashtra. They are called as 7x12 receipts. 7x12 receipts. Indian Army's Southwestern Command is conducting the exercise called Vijay Prahar in which state? They are conducting it in Suratgarh. Where is Suratgarh? It is in Rajasthan. There is a nuclear power plant in Rajasthan called Rawat Bhata. There is Tal Chapar Wildlife Sanctuary. There is, Sariska National Park. There is, there was a formula SRK. Sariska Ranthambore and Keoladio or Bharatpur. And Vasundhara Raja is the CM of Rajasthan. And now my first question for you today. How many commands are there in Indian Army and Indian Navy? Write down in comments. How much amount has the Ministry of Road Transport sanctioned for laying down 363-kilometer regional ring road around Hyderabad? This ring road will be built at an investment of 5,500 crore rupees. And it will connect Mednur to Bodhan to Nizamabad. This is another road and this is one more. So basically there is a ring road and there is one more road. Total investment will be 5,500. That's it. That's all you need to know. And Telangana, we have Amrabad Tiger Reserve in Telangana. Amrabad. Which space agency launched the AppStar 6C communication satellite? It was done by CNSA, Chinese National Space Agency. Remember name of two more, that is Beidou 3 and Tianjin 1. They are also Chinese, and there is a Zichang Satellite Launch Center. China's President is Xi Jinping. Which country has overtaken India to become the top ranked in the ICC One Day Team ranking? Now number one is England in One Day, and in T20 number one is Pakistan. Now India's ambassador to Pakistan is Ajay Bisaria, and opposite Pakistan ambassador to India is Sohail Mahmood. And Kamar Bajwa, he is the Pakistan Army Chief, and Khakan Abbasi is the Prime Minister. Union Cabinet has approved restructuring of the posts in which organization? It will be done in the Indian Bureau of Mines. Indian for the Joint Secretary level and above post, not for the lower post. Indian Bureau of Mines was set up in 1948. Now my second question for you today. Who is the Minister for Mining in India? Write down in comments. Who has been conferred with the WBC Asia Boxer of the Year Award in the welterweight category by the Asian Boxing Council at WBC Asia and WBC Muay Thai annual award ceremony that was held in the capital of Thailand, Bangkok? His name is Neeraj Goyat. Neeraj Goyat. Which country's first Deputy Prime Minister and Minister of Foreign Affairs, Ivica Dačić, met Sushma Swaraj recently, who is our External Affairs Minister? He is the first Deputy Prime Minister for Serbia. Capital is Belgrade. Which of the following items have been banned by the Ministry of Environment? The party poppers, party poppers has been banned. They are usually charged with an explosive which is activated by pulling a string, and because they contain red phosphorus, potassium chlorate, potassium perchlorate, and I mean they are not they can be explosive and they can, are harmful to the environment. Minister for Environment, Forest and Climate Change is Dr. Harshvardhan, who was conferred with the Visitors Award by President Ramnath Kovind for his work on the development of a drug delivery system for cancer. He is Professor Sanjay Jain. Professor Sanjay Jain. Ravindra Sharma passed away. He was a what? He was an artist. He was an artist. He was the founder of, there is a place in Adilabad called Kala Ashram. And he was also awarded Kala Ratan by the undivided Andhra Pradesh government. How many national resources centers have been identified by the Ministry of Human Resource Development to prepare online training material for higher education faculty under the project SWAYAM? How many? These will be 75 in number. 75 national resource centers. Employees Provident Fund Organization EPFO, they have allowed the pensioners to view their pension passbook via which app? This app is Umang app. Umang app is made by the Ministry of Electronics and Information Technology, headed by Ravi Shankar Prasad. Department of Telecom has released the draft National Digital Communication Policy called NDCP. Which of the following is not one of the main action paths listed to address the issue in the digital arena? Connect India, Propel India, Secure India, or Lead India? Which is not one of the three? It is Lead India. It is not one of the three. So Connect India is basically regarding broadband, and Propel India is regarding artificial intelligence and 5G technology, and Secure India is regarding digital communication, safety and security. Lead India is nothing. And our Minister for Communication is Manoj Sinha. These are some other objectives. Now you don't need to know that much if you are preparing for any bank PO level exam. Probably for UPSC you will be requiring this, but this was only the draft and some modifications will be made very, very soon. Vibrant Northeast Summit was recently held where? It was organized in Guwahati, which is in Assam. And the Minister for DONER, the Ministry for Development of Northeastern Region, is Dr. Jitendra Singh. Cabinet Committee on Economic Affairs has approved the continuation of Agri Umbrella Program, Green Revolution, Krishno Natti, which means Agriculture Welfare, Agriculture Development Yojana Scheme, for two more years. What is the amount that they will spend? They will spend 33,000 crore. 33,000 crore. And this program, Agri Umbrella Program, has kind of coalesced or subsumed. It has merged 11 schemes. These are the 11 schemes which have been merged into one now. Okay. Agriculture Minister is Radha Mohan Singh. Cabinet Committee on Economic Affairs has approved a proposal to build new terminals at a total cost of 5082 crore at how many airports in India? These are three airports: Chennai Airport, Guwahati Airport, and Lucknow Airport. National Mission for Clean Ganga. It has tied up with the Survey of India to facilitate the Ganga rejuvenation task using geographic information system called GIS. What will be the amount that they will spend? They will spend 87 crore rupees. The minister for the same is Nitin Gadkari. He is the minister for water resources, river development and Ganga rejuvenation. Kisan Kalyan Karyashala, which are nothing but farmers welfare workshop, they were held across India under the Gram Swaraj Abhiyan initiative on which date? This was May the 2nd. And India's target to double the farmers income is 2022. Which spacecraft has been launched by NASA to study Mars quake from the Vandenberg Air Force Base in California? The Mars quake on Mars, it is called InSight. Super important. InSight stands for Interior Exploration using Seismic Investigations, Geodesy and Heat Transport. In short, InSight. What is India's rank on the FDI Confidence Index that was released by A.T. Kearney? India fell by 3 spots. Now we are 11. Number 1 is America. Number 2 is Canada. Now, India is also the third largest producer of electricity now in the world after China and America. India is the second highest producer of mobile phones in India after China. It overtook Vietnam. Vietnam is now third. And if I talk about steel, then India overtook Japan to become second largest producer of steel after China. Which of the following has set a National Water Informatics Center called NWIC? It is set up by the Ministry of Water Resources, Ganga Rejuvenation and River Development. Central government has given its approval for acceding to the protocol under the WHO Framework Convention on what? This is regarding the tobacco control. Remember, Article 15 of the WHO Convention talks about the control on tobacco. WHO Chairman or Director General is the proper word. WHO Director General is Tedros Adhanom. He is from Ethiopia, and Deputy Director General is Soumya Swaminathan. Who chaired the first meeting of the National Committee for Commemoration of 150th Birth Anniversary of Mahatma Gandhi, which will be in 2019, 2nd of October? It was headed by Ramnath Kovind. He is the 14th President of India. Who has been appointed as the chairman of IRDAI? This is supremely important question. He will replace T.S. Vijayan. T.S. Vijayan. His name is Subhash Chandra Khuntia. As per a report by the Harvard University, which country topped the list of the fastest growing economies in the world for the coming decade? Fastest growing will be India. India is projected to grow at 7.9% annually. Tapanuli orangutan. They are facing survival threat due to human activity. The species was recently discovered in which country? It was discovered in Indonesia. They are facing threat because of One Belt, One Road and various other things. There is basically a company called Sinohydro. It is a Chinese government hydroelectric company. It is clearing the forest in Sumatra in Indonesia for their dam, which is called the Batang Toru Dam. Batang Toru Dam is very, very important. K.R. Bhushan passed away. He was a what? He was a freedom fighter, and he was also MP from Raipur constituency. So he was from Chhattisgarh. So the answer is he was a freedom fighter. How much investment has been targeted by the Power Grid Corporation of India, PGCIL, in the financial year 2009, which is the ongoing financial year? The amount that they are targeting is 25,000 crore. And who is the chairman of Power Grid? I.S. Jha. A Dakota DC-3 VP-905 aircraft was gifted by Rajya Sabha member Rajiv Chandrasekhar. It was recently inducted in Indian Air Force. This aircraft has been renamed what? It is renamed Parshuram. Parshuram. Now, Dakota, it was also known as the Guni bird. Guni bird. India-South Africa Business Summit 2018 was recently held where? It was held in Johannesburg. And India was represented by our Minister for Commerce, Industry and Civil Aviation, Suresh Prabhu. And Cape Town is suffering water crisis. Who has been appointed as the CEO of South Asia Operations by Group M? His name is Samir Singh. Which Indian javelin thrower broke his own national record and finished fourth at the IAAF Diamonds League in Doha, capital of Qatar, which will host the 2022 FIFA Football World Cup also? His name is Neeraj Chopra. Neeraj Chopra. Who launched the online event clearance system for grant of the security clearance to foreign participants of conferences organized in India? Who launched the online event? It was done by Home Secretary Rajiv Gaba, and Home Minister is Rajnath Singh. Which company has signed an agreement with Niti Aayog to develop a crop yield prediction model using artificial intelligence to provide real-time advisory to farmers in aspirational districts? And they will be judged on 49 parameters comprising of 5 fields like education, healthcare and so on. It is IBM company. Niti Aayog CEO is Amitabh Kant and Rajiv Kumar is the Vice Chairman. Who won the 2018 ONV Literary Prize? It was instituted in the memory of late poet ONV Kurup. It was won by M.T. Vasudevan Nair. This is regarding Malayalam literature. Central government has approved the continuation of Pradhan Mantri Swasthya Suraksha Yojana, PMSSY, to 2019-20. What will be the amount that they will spend on it? Amount will be 14832 crore rupees. As per the Ministry of Commerce, the growth of the 8 core sectors was recorded in March 2008 at what? It was recorded 4.1. Which are the 8 core industries in India? 8 core industries in India are coal, crude oil, natural gas, refinery products, fertilizer, steel, cement and electricity. These are the 8 core industries. So they grew 4.1% in March. Central government has approved setting up of a 100 bedded hospital and the rural health training center in Najafgarh in Delhi at a cost of what? The amount will be 95 crore rupees. As per SIPRI, Stockholm International Peace Research Institute, India has surpassed which country to become the world's 5th biggest military spender? India has now overtaken even France. Now, US is number 1, China number 2, Saudi Arabia number 3, Russia is number 4, and India now is number 5, overtaking France. Who laid down the foundation stone of a new building of the DST on its foundation day that was celebrated on May the 3rd? It was done by Dr. Harshvardhan, who is the Minister for Science and Technology. Which Indian shooter has been ranked world number 1 in 10 meter air pistol men in the latest ISSF world ranking? His name is Shahzar Rizvi. Shahzar Rizvi, he became He has also won the sole medal for India at the ISSF World Cup Stage 2 that was held in Changwon in South Korea. Who has been appointed as interim judge to the Civil Court of New York City? She is an Indian, that is why this question is important. Her name is Deepa Ambekar. Asian Development Bank President Takehiko Nakao from Japan has projected India's growth in 2018 at what? They have projected it at 7.3%. This was at the 51st ADB meeting, he announced. Who has been appointed as the acting Chief Justice of the Punjab and Haryana High Court? His name is Justice Ajay Kumar Mittal. Justice Ajay Kumar Mittal. Which railway stations have been adjudged most beautiful station on Indian Railway? Most beautiful station are Chandrapur and Ballar Shah stations. Chandrapur and Ballar Shah station. They are in Nagpur. And second prize was given to Madhubani Railway Station under Samastipur in Bihar. And the third was Kota, which is under the West Central Railway. Kota. International Firefighter Day was observed when? It was observed on May the 4th. May the 4th. The symbol is red and blue ribbon. Red and blue. Red stands for fire, blue stands for water. Which state government, along with World Wildlife Fund India, is conducting the first organized census of Indus dolphin? Indus dolphin. Remember, these are not Irrawaddy dolphins, which are maximum in Chilka Lake in Odisha. These are Indus dolphin. So it is Punjab. Punjab state government is doing it. Indus dolphin, they are found in a 185 km stretch of water between the Talwara and Harike barrage in the, you know, Bias River. That's all. How many Indian cities have featured in WHO list of 20 most polluted cities in the world in terms of the PM2.5, particulate matter 2.5 level in 2016? There are in 2014 Indian cities. The worst is Kanpur. There are Kanpur, Faridabad, Gaya, Patna, Agra, Mujaffarpur, Gurgaon, Jaipur, Jodhpur and all that. I mean, they are like 14 in PM2.5 level. And if I talk about PM10, then how many? Then 13. Union Cabinet has approved extending the investment limit for senior citizen under the Pradhan Mantri Vaya Vandana Yojana. What is the limit? Earlier it was 7.5 lakh. Now it is doubled to 15 lakh. 15 lakh. And it will enable them up to 10,000 rupees pension per month. Now remember, LIC is the agency for PMVVY. Dev Michener passed away. He was a what? He was an animator, a cartoonist. He used to work for Walt Disney. Which union minister? He chaired an interactive session on the Act East policy with the chief ministers of the northeastern states. It was done by Sushma Swaraj. And you can see in the photo here, Mizoram CM Lal Thanhaula of Congress, Arunachal Pradesh Pema Khandu, Nagaland Nephew Rio, Sikkim Paman Kumar Chamling, Assam Sarbanand Sonowal, Manipur Biren Singh, Meghalaya Conrad Sangma, and Tripura Biplab Kumar Dev. Which brokerage company has launched free intraday trading? It is launched by Kotak Security. Kotak Securities. There is a committee or a task force that was that has submitted its report to the Home Minister on establishing a coalition on disaster resilient infrastructure called CDRI. This task force was headed by which person? It was headed by Preeti Saran. And who is she? She is secretary in the for East in the Ministry of External Affairs. Fourth regional conference on futurist resilient and digital infrastructure was recently held where? It was held in Bengaluru. It was organized by the Ministry of Finance in association with CII and RIS. CII is Confederation of Indian Industry. RIS is Research for Information System for Developing Countries. So the answer is Bengaluru, capital of Karnataka. Who has become the first African to be named Footballer of the Year by Footballers Writer Association? He is Mohamed Salah. He is from Egypt. Egypt president is Abdel Fattah al-Sisi. And Cairo is the capital. There is a river called Nile. There are the Great Pyramids. There is Tahrir Square. Egypt is a great country. Cabinet Committee on Economic Affairs has approved renaming multi-sectoral development program called MSDP as what? Now it will be called Pradhan Mantri Jan Vikas Karyakram. Jan Vikas, no, PMJVK. Jan Vikas, which means development of people. Karyakram, which means program. And this is these are some features. So for 3 years, from 2017-18 to 19-20, the amount will be 3972 crore. It is aimed at providing better socio-economic infrastructure facility to the minority community in India. So this is, it will cover 308 district. Who chaired the committee or a task force set up by the International Solar Alliance, which is headquartered in Gurugram in Haryana, and it has identified 6 star centers of global excellence? It is Masayoshi Son, and he is the chairman of the SoftBank Group. SoftBank Group. Which company launched a new Shepard suborbital capsule to space with a dummy astronaut named Mannequin Skywalker? It is done by the company Blue Origin from West Texas. And founder of Blue Origin is Jeff Bezos, the richest person on the planet. When was World Asthma Day observed? On the theme, never too early, never too late. It is always the right time to address airway disease. World Asthma Day is 1st of May. Union Cabinet has approved mutual recognition agreement of ICAI, Indian Institute of Chartered Accountant, with the Institute of Chartered Accountants of which country? This was done with the South Africa's Institute of Chartered Accountants. GST Council's 27th meeting, they approved a new simplified model of filing return. It will be implemented after how many months? It will be implemented after 6 months. This will provide for one monthly return for all taxpayers except composition dealers who are a part of the composite scheme. Which state government has announced to adopt the startup ranking framework that was issued by the Department of Industrial Policy and Promotion? It will be done by the government of Haryana. CM is Manohar Lal Khattar. And who was sworn in as the governor of Manipur? It is Jagdish Mukhi. Jagdish Mukhi. And he will hold the office in the absence of Governor Najma Abdullah. And he is the governor of Assam and Meghalaya. Jagdish Mukhi. So this was the video. Now I finish first week. And tomorrow onwards, I will start second week. So second week, part 1, current affairs will be uploaded tomorrow. This is the first time that I have uploaded the video in English language. First, hoping for a good response. Thank you so much. And before I wind off, I want to remind you about our pen drive courses. These are prepared by some of the best faculty. And you can really get an edge in any of these exams if you avail those. These are paid courses. So if you want to buy those, you can go to studyiq.com. Thank you so much.